Nah. Yeah, leave the hissing in there. Don't take the hissing out. We gon' keep this one all the way gangster. I mean, you motherfuckers don't realize how real this shit is, man. I mean, people always gon' try and get over on you. But protect what's yours. Protect your family. Protect what's right. Yeah. The story starts off, little boy black in the ghetto. No matter what he does, it's back to the ghetto. Ghetto. No choice but to adapt to the ghetto. So he adapts to the ghetto. Yes, the crack in the metal. He takes no days off for getting his cocaine off. He ran back and forth so much it pissed Jose off. Now Jose was the cocaine boss. Straight from Colombia, his cocaine sauce. While Jose was out fucking his sister, hitting Shorty off cause he had love for his sister. And Shorty had no love for his sister, cause his sister would sniff up everything Jose gives her. But Shorty had a plan for them both, cause he was good at handling coke. So Jose liked him. The problem was, he was pitching for the dudes down the street. You know, CJ, Big Boo, and Malik. Malik is a killer, Boo is a killer. Yeah. CJ, well, he's just another nigga, but despite the fact,
what?
They didn't like the fact that he was close to Jose and he might just rap. And being that he was a pitcher here and a winner there, they set it up to get him near and hit him near.
Damn.
But Shorty was smart, so before they got to load up his spark, he said, hold up my heart,
hold up,
please. And he said, please, look up in my bag. It's cook up in my bag, it's all good up in my bag.
Yeah.
And it's more where that came from. I get it from Jose. Believe me, it's more where that came from. Yeah, he had him lost in the game one. They let him go, yeah, thinking he would let him know
what?
Where Jose was keeping the heavy coat. But instead he told Jose about that.
About that.
And we all know Jose about that.
About that.
Next thing you know he seen Jose slouch back.
What?
In a chair like it's no way out that.
Nope.
He said shoot him, I'ma blow they house back.
Back.
Next day he sent the two-way out town. And somebody blew they house down. Jose thinks Shorty on his side, but he don't know Shorty on his side. So Shorty called Jose, like
listen,
it's going down, I need more cocaine.
Bring it.
So we met up.
Met up,
it was a setup, guess who? TJ, Malik, and Boo sped up. You should've seen the look on Jose's face. You never seen a look on no man's face.
No,
told him no man's great, and it's no man's place to fuck with no man's fan. Then he said, where's my sister for a kid?
The end.
Story's over, man.
It's over, man.
They all kinda end like that sometimes too. You dig? You see, I told this story cause man, I kinda feel like every hood, everybody's got Lil Boy Fresh around them somewhere. Whether it's right next door, across the hall, up the block, down the block, around the corner. I mean you see we all see the same shit just through different eyes. You surprised? Don't be, man. It's just real shit. I'll ask your boy Dipset. Aight.